إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. فالحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا. فالحمد لله الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا. فالحمد لله الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض ولم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك وخلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر ويتم نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما. وقال الله تعالى ورفعنا لك ذكرك. وقال الله تعالى إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, again we are going through the first Jummah of the lockdown. Inshallah it will end soon, after 1 month or so. This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will go through inshallah very patiently. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah, our salawat, and our good deeds. Ameen. Another area I need to talk about is, which is also a current issue, is the non-believers. We are all aware that they are trying to defame our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is really hurtful for all the Muslim Ummah, for whole Muslim Ummah in the entire world. And this is not the first attempt by the non-believers. This has been happening throughout the entire human history. Even in the lifetime of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people, non-believers, they used to defame Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they used to bully Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They used to give hard time emotionally and physically to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sahaba. And it is hurtful. It is very, very, very painful. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recognized this in the Quran when he addressed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. I know it is painful. This is one of the way of consoling someone when he is going through difficulty, that you just say a word of comfort like, I know it's very hard. I know you are going through a very hard time in your life. Inshallah, this will end soon. These are the words of comfort which we usually say to our fellow human beings when we see them in difficulty. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Hijr is recognizing the pain of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's saying it. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. I know. Allah is saying, I know that it's very painful for you. They are saying different things about you. They are saying you are a magician. They are saying you are a liar. هَذَا سَحِرٌ كَذَّابٌ. When somebody says us liar, again and again, wherever he meets us, in the streets, in the mosque, wherever he says us, in the wedding ceremony, he says, you are liar, you are liar, liar. It's very painful when somebody repeatedly says this to us. This is kind of a bullying. So imagine Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is hearing this at every corner of the streets in Mecca. Sahir, kazzab, liar, magician. So these were the bullying words and other things. Walan qadna alam. I know it's very painful. Annaka yadiku sadruka bima yaqulun. That this is really hurtful. This is really a burden on your chest, on your heart. Whatever they are saying about you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Fasabbih bihamdi rabbik. You just praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this difficult time, Ya Rasulullah. Inshallah, this time will be over. Today again, my brothers and sisters, we are going through this difficult time, very painful time. The non-believers, they are trying their best to say things about our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we need to turn to the tasbih of Allah as it's advised in this ayah. Fasabbih bihamdi rabbik. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was going through this pain, Allah advised him, you just pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most powerful. He is saying to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that you just praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They can't do anything against you. Whatever they are saying, their legacy will end and your legacy will continue. When on such occasions in the Meccan life, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was bullied. He was made fun of by the kuffar, especially when he was going through this hurtful phase in Meccan life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Surah Al-Kawthar, a small surah. And this surah, we must understand, this is the consolation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are the words of sympathy by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son Abdullah passed away, he was very worried, and you know, your infant child, a year or so old, when he passes away, we as a father can understand how, imagine he is the only son. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the only son at that time. He had daughters at that time, but this was the first son. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going through very difficult time, he was like sad, sitting amongst his sahaba. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the word of sympathy, the word of consolation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consoled Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this ayah. Because the kuffar, they were celebrating the death of infant son of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine if someone dies in your family, even the worst enemy, he will come to you and will say the word of console. Even his heart melts. Even he shares the pain. They will say to you that, yes, we are enemies. We are not in reconciliation. We are not friend. But because the pain you are going through at the moment as a human being, I can feel the same pain. Even your enemies come to you and he rings you and will share the sympathetic words with you. Imagine Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son died. And Abu Lahab, his real uncle. You know, when someone outside your family member, if he gives hard time to you, then it's understandable. Celebrating the death of your son, he is running through the streets and he's saying, Qad butira Muhammad, Qad butira Muhammad. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is imputated. His progeny is going to discontinue. He is laughing in the streets. Imagine he is laughing and celebrating because he had this understanding of Jahiliya that if you don't have son, that your progeny, your name will discontinue. Because the girls, they married in other families, in other tribes. It's your son who lives with you, who carries your progeny, your family name, your surname, and your tribal legacy onward. It's only your son. So this was the understanding. And Prophet ﷺ obviously had no son, and he had son, he passed away. And Kufar, they were celebrating that now he had no son at all. And his name, his legacy will obviously discontinue. And it was very hurtful for the Prophet ﷺ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is consoling Prophet ﷺ in this small surah that Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. We have given you kawthar, Ya Rasulullah. Don't worry about your son. If he is passed away, Allah will give you followers who will be more to you than the real son can be to anyone, to any father. And that's really is the case. The followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are ready to give their life for the name, for the sake of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even the real son, sometimes they don't do it. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is given such a followings. They love Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than their own children, more than their own father and mother. And this was the usual wording of the Sahaba, his direct followers, Fida ka ummi wa abi ya Rasulullah. May my father and mother be sacrificed for the sake of you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May I give up my father and mother, Ya Rasulullah, for the sake of you. Fida ka ummi wa abi ya Rasulullah. So this was the usual phrase by the Sahaba, by the followers, by the direct prophet of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even today, after so many centuries, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had followers. We love Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why not? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, your iman is not complete until you love Allah and His messenger more than your own father, your own mother, your own children, your own family. So this is the criteria set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our iman. We have to love, we have to have that love if we really and truly the believers and the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is what in this surah mean kawthar. Inna a'tayna kal kawthar. Kawthar has many meanings. One of the meaning obviously is the hawd, the fountain which will be given to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment. And on the day of judgment, there won't be any water or canal or fountain around. Everything on the day of judgment will be destroyed. Is a shamsu kuvirat, is a samaun fatarat. Yeah, and sun and the moon and the sky, everything, mountain, everything will be destroyed, and the earth will be flattened. The sea will be destroyed. So there won't be any water supply on the day of judgment. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be gifted a fountain on the day of judgment, and all the followers, real followers of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will drink water from the fountain gifted by Allah to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this will be the fountain. Everybody will be drinking water on the day of judgment, when there will be no water supply around. And this will be because of the gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in this surah, Inna a'tayna kal kawthar. But kawthar has other meanings as well, apart from the meaning of hawd, the fountain. Kausar mean khair kaseer, and one of the meaning is that the legacy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his name will remain forever in the hearts of the people until the day of judgment. His legacy and his followings, even after he has left this world, his followers will continue to believe him, to believe in him and to follow him until the day of judgment. You cannot find any such precedent, any other human being who has so much followings even after he has passed away. You see, so many people still love Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than their own family. This is the part of iman. This is another gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is meant here when he said inna a'tayna kal kausar. And you know, one of the small surah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said wa rafa'na laka zikrak, we have, this is surah inshirah, alam nashrah laka sadrak, and this is one of the ayah from the surah wa rafa'na laka zikrak, we have raised your mentioning, ya Rasulullah, we have raised your mentioning in the entire world, ya Rasulullah, wa rafa'na laka zikrak. And this also means that the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is made known popular in the entire world, in the entire universe. You know, the most popular name, even if the most popular name typed in the Google is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not just the Muslims who type it, it's the non-Muslims as well. They want to know about this man as well, although they don't believe in him, out of the curiosity and the popularity, they want to search this name. Who is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So the Muhammad is the most popular name which is typed in the Google. So even, you know, the Muslims, obviously 99%, even the 100%, I would say, they name their children Muhammad, either the first name or the second name, Muhammad Abdullah, Muhammad Salim, Muhammad Abdul Rahman. So Muhammad or Ahmad, same thing, Muhammad, Ahmad, the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the most popular name. So every Muslim is called Muhammad or Ahmad, either first name or second. This shows the harikasi. This shows inna a'atayna kal kausar. This shows the followings, the lovers of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And also, wa rafa'na laka zikrak. This is the ayah where Allah said, we have raised your mentioning and the name, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jibreel came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he gave the tafsir of this ayah, what this ayah means. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam told the tafsir of this ayah to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, this ayah means wa rafa'na laka zikrak, when Allah said that your name will be raised high, ya Rasulullah, it means that wherever the name of Allah will be mentioned, the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be mentioned soon after. And we see this in reality, that whenever we say Allah's name, we mention the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just like in our kalima, basic thing, la ilaha illallah, we mention Allah, then what comes next? La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even our kalima, it witnesses that whenever Allah's name is mentioned, the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned soon after. So this is the legacy of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the love by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And again, my brothers and sisters, we do azan, and in every azan, whenever we say Ashhadu Allah ilaha illallah, what comes next? Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Even in the azan, and how many times azan is given? 5 times a day. And again, because of the time difference, maybe here it's a daytime and somewhere could be night time. When it's night time here, somewhere in America or Switzerland or in New Zealand, it could be night time. So every time, every moment around the world, there is somewhere azan time. Somewhere, someone in some masjid, whether it's daytime or night time, somewhere, someone is saying either La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, or someone somewhere in some masjid around the world is saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. So it is something round the clock, 24 hours. Prophet's name is mentioned 24 hours every moment. And listen, how many people they give azan and how many people hear the azan and they say, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So imagine the mentioning of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When we look at these details, then we actually tend to forget what the non-believers say about our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah has already raised him so high, we don't care. We don't care what the non-believers say. Their saying is nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the name of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who cares what the mankind say? If the Lord of the mankind raises the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who cares what the mankind says? So this is again the consolation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and also to us. And you know, when we mention the legacy, the honor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's really amazing. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave so many commands in the Quran: pray, fast, wa aqimus salah, wa atu zakah. So simple command, pray, just like I command someone, give me a glass of water, give me this, do that. We do simple command. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran gave so many commands. Do this, don't do that. Wala taqrabu zina, simple command. Wala taqrabu salah. So simple command given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. But when he commanded, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never said, I pray as well, so you should pray. I fast as well. Allah never said that. Allah never. Sometimes we say to children, oh my children, oh my son, you should pray. I pray as well. Your mom pray as well. Just as an encouragement that what we are commanding to you, we do the same. We say to our, don't lie. I never lied my son in my life. So we set ourselves as an example to our son, I never did this, so my son, you don't this. You pray. I always pray in my life, my son. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he commanded to the Muslims that we should send durood upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I send durood upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well. Angels sent durood upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you, O believers, should send the durood upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam too. Inna Allah, this is the ayah from Surah Ahzab. Inna Allah wa malaikata, verily Allah and his angels. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabiy. We all send darood, salawat upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah himself sends, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, send darood upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the honor. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, you believe, sallu alayhi. You sent darood upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah could have simply said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu ala rasul. Oh, you believe, send darood upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Simple command. But Allah begins like this, that inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. It's just a matter of giving honor to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah sent. So we send darood upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is actually the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu darood all the time upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Angels send darood upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the time, and the number of angels are countless. They are not like humans. They are not like human. Their number, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّهُ. Only Allah knows their number. We cannot even put a number on them. We cannot say billion or because we do not have the figure. Maybe it's beyond any specified figure, their number. Because you can imagine, when the angels come to the earth in the night of Laylatul Qadr, in the night of Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in your Qadr, one of the meaning of Qadr is congestion. You know, when sometime on the road, the traffic is so much that the cars are like neck to neck. They are behind each other. The whole road is like blocked because of the traffic rush. This is congestion. So the angels in Laylatul Qadr, they come so much that they cause congestion. And one of the meaning of Qadr is congestion. Qadr means congestion, congestion. So much rush. So because angels come so, there are so many in numbers, when they come to earth in Laylatul Qadr, the whole earth is occupied by them like a traffic rush, Qadr. And that is why they are so human. Even if the entire humanity gather, they cannot fill the whole earth. It's the angels. They are so many in number. And they are sending the darood, salawat upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah is sending darood. Human beings are sending darood, salawat, blessings upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the entire world, round the clock, 24 hours. Who cares if few non-Muslims, they are trying to defame Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa rafa'na laka zikrak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is raising the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is like a consolation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is another point I would like to bring this up, my brothers and sisters. You know, sometimes out of respect, we don't call people by their name. I don't call my father by his name. I always say dad, abbaji, abuji, yeah? Out of respect, obviously. We don't call our mom by name. We always say ammiji, yeah? My mother, my mom. We never call out of respect. Sometimes the wives, they don't call their husbands by name. It's all sign of respect. And my brothers and sisters, this is another subtle point I want to bring this up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of respect, never called our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by name. He never said in the Quran, Ya Muhammad, Ya Muhammad. In Arabic, we call Ya Aba, Ya Muhammad. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called, mentioned other prophets by name. Ya Ibrahim, Ya Musa, Inni and Allahu Rabbul Alameen, Ya Musa Aqbil, Ya Ibrahim, Ya Yahya, Hudil Kitaba bi Quwwa. So all other prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Yahya, Ya, O Yahya, O Ibrahim. There's only one prophet, the last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the honor. This is the respect Allah is giving to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never mentioned in the Quran, Ya Muhammad. He always called Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by his title. The title is Abba Jan, Ami Jan, Dr. Saab, Hafiz Saab. So these are the titles. We use these titles out of respect. We don't call people by name out of respect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never called Ya Muhammad. He always called Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by his title. Ya Rasulullah, Ya Ayyuhal Muzzammil, Ya Ayyuhal Muddassir, Muhammadur Rasulullah. So the messenger of Allah, even the Sahaba, they never called Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam Ya Muhammad. They always called him by name, Ya Rasulullah. Even his wife, even his uncle, you know, even his uncle, Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he became Muslim. He always, whenever he narrated a hadith, he said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never said, Qala Ammi, my uncle said. Uncle and all other titles just left behind. Rasulullah, the messenger of, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best friend of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And whenever he narrated a hadith, he never said, Qala Siddiqi, my friend said. He always said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He, the Sahaba, even the wife, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, the wife, you have very personal relationship. Still, she never used the name of Prophet sallallahu, always said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Sahaba, this is the honor which is given, which we see in the traditions, in the Islamic tradition, given to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can you see any other example, any other human being who is given so much honor by the Lord of the mankind, by the mankind, by his followers? No, we cannot see any other example. So who cares but few non-Muslim, they try to defame Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they can never be successful, because as I mentioned in the beginning of my khutbah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Suratul Kawthar, Inna a'atayna kal kawthar fasalli li rabbika wanhar. We have given you kaseer, khair kaseer. And khair kaseer, doesn't just mean the fountain which is going to be given on the day of judgment. It means the legacy, the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will continue to be mentioned until the day of judgment, even after the day of judgment, even the next life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rank him at such a place which is called Maqame Mahmood, where the whole humanity, kuffar, non-Muslim, Muslim, the whole humanity will praise him, because on that day the truth will be clear. Everybody would know that he is really a true prophet. All the non-Muslim, they might reject him today, but on the day of judgment, they will praise him. That is why he will be given the Muqam of Mahmood on the day of judgment. And let alone the next world, even in this world, he is given this legacy. As I mentioned, that although the non-Muslims, they say few non-Muslims, but mostly even the non-Muslims, they try to search in the Google the name Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who is this man? So this is the legacy of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Few highlights I could bring in this short khutbah. So inshallah, this will increase our love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the love of Allah and the love of Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.